Hey, church family, I just wanted to take this opportunity to provide you with another word of encouragement as we continue to pray for the end of this pandemic. According to Dr. Oz, there are 9 symptoms commonly experienced by those who have COVID-19. These symptoms include a dry cough, sore throat, shortness of breath, headache, loss of smell or taste, as well as digestive issues like vomiting and diarrhea, not to mention chills, fever, and finally, fatigue. Now, I'm sure that we've all experienced a few of these illness indicators. And yet it's those who have all 9 symptoms who also have good reason to think that they've contracted the novel coronavirus. In a similar yet spiritual way, there are also several symptoms of spiritual rebellion, which are demonstrated by believers who are beginning to backslide. These symptoms include a loss of appetite for the spiritual disciplines of prayer, daily devotion, Bible study, and evangelism. And not only that, but the backsliding believer will also struggle with the bitterness that's caused by unforgiveness. And finally, the backsliding believer will begin to make provisions for the depraved desires of their fallen flesh. Now, if you're beginning to demonstrate some of these symptoms, if these symptoms are true of you, then I hope you'll receive the advice that Paul presented in Romans chapter 13. It's there where he declares, "The night is far spent, the day is at hand. Therefore, let us cast off the works of darkness, and let us put on the armor of light. Let us walk properly as in the day, not in revelry and drunkenness, not in lewdness and lust, not in strife and envy, but put on the Lord Jesus Christ, and make no provision for the flesh to fulfill its lusts." Christian, listen, those who begin to make provisions for the flesh, those who are making provision for their carnal appetites, they'll soon become believers who are living in bondage to their depraved desires. And it's for this reason that Paul encouraged us to cast off the works of darkness. Let's cast off the works of darkness so that we can put on the armor of light. Simply put, let's put on the Lord Jesus Christ, and let's make no provisions for our flesh so that we can avoid those lusts that would lead us back into a life of sin. Let's continue to walk in the way that is pleasing to the Lord so that we can become those believers who bring glory to God. Finally, I want to remind you that you can join us for our weekly services, which include a midweek study, Wednesdays at 7 p.m., as well as our Sunday morning service, which is now at 10 a.m. Both studies are streaming live online right here at calvarysouthaustin.com. I hope to see you here. God bless you.